On the other side of Cornwall, the Mount Pleasant Eco Park is home to local enterprises, workshops, a gallery and campsite, all of them founded on sustainability principles, starting with the four walls and roof over their heads. The main building has the largest load-bearing rammed earth wall in the UK.
The rammed earth walls in this building are its main feature. Its alternative is concrete, which has a very high embodied energy, i.e. a lot of energy goes into the extraction of the raw material, the processing of the raw material and the transportation. So rammed earth has the lowest embodied energy of any material. It's a raw material that doesn't need processing and we dig it straight from the site, so there's no transport costs.
You can't put up a building like this just anywhere. The rammed earth technique is site specific, but other features could be adopted more widely.
What we've got on the roof of the workshops here is recycled rubber tiles. And they're made out of car tyres. It's a recycled product, it's light, it's easy to fix. We've tried to incorporate in the building as many sort of energy saving and recycling options as possible. We've got a rainwater harvesting system, which supplies water to the toilets. We've got solar panels to heat hot water in the summer. And we've got a biomass boiler, which is a really good facility for us because it gets rid of all the wood waste from the timber frame company and heats the workspace in the unit.
Tim's originally a woodworker and his business specialises in timber-framed buildings using locally sourced wood with an environmental accreditation, such as the Forest Stewardship Council certification.
It just means that it's a source from a sustainable source and there's a chain of custody. So there's a paper trail from the mill to make sure it's being sourced from sustainable plantations, not just clear felled forest.
One of the problems faced by architects and builders that want to work in this environmentally sensitive way is that the initial costs can be higher than more mainstream methods. How can their kind of ecologically sustainable construction compete to become the norm?
You've got to look at the payback time. So if the initial costs are more expensive, but within 3 years you've saved on your heating bills or your electricity bills, and the lifespan of the building's 50 years, well, it's obviously a good investment. The building control that regulate the house building process is getting more up to date in what is required to make a building sustainable and energy efficient. So therefore, house builders are being forced down a sustainable route.
Tim's most recent commission is a timber-framed building for a local government regeneration project, Tucking Mill Valley Park. The initial cost was paid for by a government grant. It will serve as an education centre and offices for the British Trust for Conservation Volunteers, who will in return help maintain the site, a former arsenic and gas works.
We were very keen to show the project off as a centre of excellence. We wanted it to be not just excellence in conservation, but also excellence in sustainability. This building in particular, with its turf roof, very good insulation, so that the long-term costs of putting a building in like this are going to be significantly lower than a conventional build. The insulation is all sort of recycled materials. We're trying to use a lot of recycling on the project.
As it happens, this building was comparable in price to more conventional ones, but it has other advantages from the council's point of view.
The capital costs and the revenue costs are very different. By putting a building in like this, which is sustainable, it's going to lower the long-term revenue costs, and that's very important from a council's perspective.
The shift to a more sustainable way of building like this can't just rely on committed pioneers. Civil society, the market and the state all have to play a part.
There's two ways of doing it, really, from the government. There's either the carrot method or the stick method. This has been certainly the carrot method, where people have been offered grants to deliver sustainable sort of features as part of the works.
What changes markets is the demand. And I think clients, the end users of buildings, are going to demand more energy efficient housing because of the escalating price of energy.
These environmental pioneers have taken sustainability principles off the drawing board and applied them to their own projects. This doesn't mean they've found the answers for everyone, but they've learned how to ask the right questions.